My passion is to help leaders and their teams find that missing spark that helps them really get energized to do meaningful work. It's fantastic to be with people and see when it clicks and they realize that actually living and leading through a values-based approach is the best way, the only way, to find the energy to do that meaningful work and to find that missing spark. I love to be with people. I love to be on stage presenting and to feel that energy back from the audiences as they go through the process that I talk about. It's absolutely fantastic. But we know the pandemic changed all that. Suddenly, we weren't able to be face to face. Leaders faced the same challenge, leading their teams online, their remote teams. And those of us who speak, myself included, we had the same issue. We had to find a way to reach our audiences online. Now, I adapted. I actually speak about how to adapt because that is my theme. I talk about stoic, courageous leadership, how to adapt and find resilience in difficult moments. And so I did that by going online. And I have to say, it's been absolutely fantastic. I've given over 30 talks online to audiences across the globe. Whether it be on Zoom or Teams or Google Meets, it's been amazing to use the power of the technology because you can engage with people. You can use polls and chats and even speak to them one-on-one, even more sometimes than when you're in a room with people. And the technology itself has been fun to play with, to add to the whole experience that people get from seeing a speaker. Now, I had the pleasure to speak to people across the globe, from South America to South Africa, from Europe to Asia, from the East Coast to the West Coast of the United States. Audiences that have been able to see me and me meet loads of new friends and connect with them as well. And do what I love, which is talk about how ancient philosophy can be used with modern science to find the best way to lead resilient teams and happy teams in the workplace. And I talk about leadership and how, in fact, ancient philosophies like Stoicism can be used to help leaders apply very practical tools to take away and use with their teams in the workplace. And I use examples from history and from the modern day. And he was considered by most to be the very best. In fact, Edward Gibbon, who wrote the famous book, The Decline and Fall of the Roman Empire, he said this about Marcus Aurelius. He said, he actually reigned over the period in the history of the world during which the condition of the human race was most happy and prosperous. Now, this man is the greatest swimmer the world has ever seen, and also the greatest Olympian. His name is Michael Phelps. It's been a great journey, and I'm really looking forward now to going back on stage and to engaging again with people live and meeting people face to face. But I won't be leaving this virtual digital medium because it's also been amazing to connect so many people across the globe that I wouldn't have met and they wouldn't have seen me either. Now, I'm continuing to give the very best I can, the best value, the best product to my audience and my clients, to give them something they can really practically use that inspires them, that finds that spark to give them what they need to engage at work. Now, whether I'll be doing that on a stage or whether it's online, I really look forward to seeing you at one of my events soon.